inflate the balloon, leaving a 7-inch flat tail. First, we have to make the mermaid body, and we use different balloon for the body. The body can be done in different ways. Here's a short overview of one basic mermaid body. I play this video clip on high speed. Previously, I have described how to make the body in a number of instructions. Most of the doll's body can be used for our purpose. So we have to make the doll body without the legs. We will attach the tail instead of legs. Here I cut off the part of the balloon where supposed to be the legs. Don't cut it too short. We need about 1-inch flat balloon to tie the body to the tail. Tie off the end of the pink balloon. So the body bubble is about 3-inch and the flat tail is about 1-inch. Now I'm going to tie the pink body balloon to the blue tail balloon. I leave about 1/2-inch flat tail between the pink balloon and the blue balloon. Here you can see it. We're going to use the tulip twist to make the proper connection between these two balloons. Twist the first soft 1/2-inch bubble. For the first blue bubble inside of the blue balloon. Here you can see the blue first bubble is going inside of the blue balloon. For the first blue bubble, about 4-inch inside of the blue balloon, or as far as the flat tail of the body can stretch. Most likely the blue balloon will bend in the shape of a letter C, some kind of a hook. And it's okay. Just keep forcing the first blue bubble as far inside of the blue balloon as you can. Once you get it about 3-4 inches inside of the blue balloon, here we can twist the second blue bubble. I twisted the second blue 3-inch bubble. Probably it is the most difficult part of the tail. The rest of the tail is much easier to make. Twist the third blue 3-inch bubble. By the way, the first blue bubble is inside of the third blue bubble. Twist the fourth 1-inch bubble. Twist the fifth 1-inch bubble. Twist the sixth 1-inch bubble. Twist the seventh 1-inch bubble. Twist the eighth 1-inch bubble. Twist the ninth 1-inch bubble. And twist the 10th 3-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 blue bubbles in one lock twist. Now we are going to split the tail on two parts. Twist the 11th 3-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 bubbles in one lock twist. Just for the free end of the 11th bubble between the 6th and the 7th bubbles. It is good enough. Twist the 12th 3-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. Congratulations, we have made the mermaid tail. The rest of the blue balloon is the 13th bubble. We can use it as a handle or cut it off and tie off the end. Now I'm going to use a gold color balloon to make the hair for our mermaid. It could be done in different ways. Let's tie the gold balloon between the head and the body bubbles. Once again, I'm going to play this video clip on faster speed. Previously in different instructions, I have described this part. Just for this sculpture, I arrange the hair bubbles in a similar shape as the mermaid tail. Not exactly the same, of course, just similar. We have to fix the arm bubbles once we're done with the hair. let's lock both ends of the hand bubble in one lock twist. Now we lock both ends of the other hand bubble in one lock twist. We can split the hand bubble on two smaller hand bubbles. This way the dough looks better and the lock twist is more secure. One hand is done. Let's do the same with the other hand bubble. Split it on two small bubbles. There is a middle 1-inch bubble between two arms. We can bust it to split arms apart or leave it, it's all up to you. I would rather use scissors to cut this middle bubble. Boom! It was me, not the bubble. I always remove all balloon squeaky sound from video instructions. Instead I add my own squeaky sound. Okay, let's use a permanent black marker to draw the face of the mermaid. Basically we're all done. Let's see what else we can do to decorate the mermaid. Let's make blue soft 1-inch bubble. It should be very soft. Tie both ends of this bubble in one knot. Make sure the knot is securely tied. So now we have 1-inch soft bubble with one end only. Let's split this bubble on two bubbles of the same size. The knot we keep in the between bubbles. We are going to attach these two blue bubbles between the body and the head bubbles, or between the arms bubbles. Just force the blue knot and wrap it a couple times between the pink bubbles. Take your time, fix the small two bubbles nicely. I fix the small blue bubbles right under the pink arm bubbles. Here we are. Here's the front view, here's the side view, the back view. Have to fix the hair. Okay, now here's the back view, the side view, now I have to fix the front. Yeah. This mermaid tail can be used to make different balloon sculptures. An elephant head, a fan for example, etc. Here's the bottom view. Have fun and happy tasting.